A truly excellent Monday Night Raw. Apart from obviously the massive incident with Seth Rollins, which we got all the information, all the details of what went on there. And we will talk about it. It's not really something I want to talk about. But of course, it is a massive part of the show. It's something everyone's talking about. But this is, of course, things you might have missed. And before we get started, make sure you've hit the like button. And if you are new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button too. Let's start this on a positive note, okay? Seth Rollins came out in the main event. He seemingly was perfectly okay, and I'm really pleased for that. But of course, the incident we're talking about happened earlier on in the night when Seth Rollins was attacked by a complete and utter clown masquerading to be a fan of WWE. Obviously, this is exactly what went down. You can see it right here. This is the moment on TV that we saw the referee there tries to get involved. And fair play, because the referee's out there alone with Seth. I don't know where the security was. If I was WWE, I would not be happy about that. There is also fan footage showing the moment of... it's shocking. Obviously, other officials do arrive to help Seth. This is off of television. WWE cut away from this moment. And I don't blame them at all. This is a very scary situation where, let's be honest, anything could have happened. This fan was definitely unhinged, and he could have been carrying any number of different weapons that could cause serious damage to any other person. And Seth Rollins was in serious danger here, and I think it's god awful. Well, there was obviously footage of the fan, I hate calling him a fan, being led out of the arena by security. And go away. Honestly, you're not welcome at these shows. Why? Look at him getting aggressive with other fans as he's being led out of the arena. It's absolutely disgusting. And I'm really pleased Seth Rollins is okay. The image that stood out to me was seeing Becky on the stage, obviously checking on her husband. And they've just recently had a kid, and it's scary, man. Well, WWE have issued the statement that they take safety of all its performers seriously. The individual was turned over to the NYPD and will be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. I can't lie, I thought this was Big E. I thought this was maybe Gable Steveson coming down and attacking Seth. I thought it was part of the show, and I'm really just pleased Seth's okay. On a brighter note, WWE had new graphics for Raw this week. Of course, they showed them throughout the show. Really like all of them. I think they all look really, really crisp. You can see the Raw logo gets a new like texture to it, which I thought was quite nice. Really does stand out a lot better. Also, did you notice Matt Riddle was wearing Drew Gulak's trunks? Like, literally, they said Gulak. I thought that was hilarious. Now, the biggest story going into Raw from Survivor Series last night was who stole Vince McMahon's Cleopatra egg. And of course, Sonya Deville and Adam Pearce did track it down thanks to Sami Zayn to beat Austin Theory. And I thought he was going to get his pink slip. But no, obviously Vince McMahon saw himself in Austin Theory and instead decided to take a selfie with the rookie. And of course, Vince McMahon gave him a WWE title match. Poor Sami Zayn. Honestly, poor Sammy. But of course, Sammy did get a US title match against Damian Priest. Sammy obviously is a SmackDown star. It was a bit of a crossover tonight. And obviously, Damian Priest was victorious. And I don't understand why Apollo didn't want the match with Damian Priest. Surely you want to be champion. I don't understand that. But I'm okay with this because, you know what? It actually did a good job for Austin Theory. You kind of get him that credibility that Vince likes him and that he's got potential. And then you put him in a WWE title match. That's pretty damn cool. And yes, he lost that match, but there was reasons. Owens and Seth arguing on the outside had Austin Theory distracted, which allowed Big E to pick up the win. So you've actually done a good job there of protecting Austin Theory while still building the Big E feuds that are currently ongoing. Zelina Vega and Kane. Carmella won the women's tag team championships this week on Raw. I only say Kane because, well, look at the red mask. She obviously debuted this last night at Survivor Series, but did you notice that she went straight to Corey Graves to celebrate winning the women's tag team title? Corey was marking out and fair play. You know what? I'm not completely opposed to this. I think they are a more established tag team than probably Rhea and Nikki. So let's see what they can do with it. They just need opponents now. Becky Lynch confronted Liv Morgan tonight. Of course, the number one contender for the Raw Women's title. And there was a cool moment when Becky even mentioned the fact that Liv's friends are no longer there. Obviously, a reference to the Riot Squad. This was complete bullying. But Liv smacked Becky straight in the face. Whoa! Liv is not messing around. And I don't blame her at all. I'm here for a fired up Liv Morgan. And yes, we have to talk about him. Wyndham, Bray Wyatt. There's a lot of Bray Wyatt news all of a sudden. Of course, we spoke just the other day about the fact that Smiths will be getting the Holiday Fiend Funko Pop, which I'm super excited for. But now on WWE Shop is a brand new Fiend Holiday Light Up Sweater. What? Where has this come from? His 90 days has expired, and we now know his first appearance has been announced. It is the Dallas WrestleCon in 2022. So if you're around Dallas, check it out. But notice they're still referencing The Fiend and Bray Wyatt here. Not a new character. Does that rule out AEW already? We had a new 24/7 champion as Cedric Alexander beat Reggie in a match. And then, of course, Dana Brooke come down and beat Cedric Alexander. I thought this was okay. I'm okay with Dana Brooke getting a moment like this. I love the fact all the men were there and obviously refused to do anything, giving Dana Brooke an opportunity to shine. Why not? Honestly, why not? You're not doing anything else with her. The 24/7 title division is seen by most to be a joke. So why not let it try to actually do something? I'm here for it. RK-Bro proved tonight why they are probably the most entertaining thing on WWE television right now, for sure. Matt Riddle dressed up as Randy Orton. He had the facial hair and everything. I love this so much. It was so freaking cool. Honestly, Riddle looked amazing doing it. Yes, he was wearing Drew Gulak's underwear, basically. But obviously, it was Riddle that picked up the win. And Randy loved it by the end. Of course, imitating Riddle with the bro Derek. I thought that was quite fun. Honestly, just give me more RK bro WWE. Give them, like, comedy segments where they go out for dinner or something. Just give me more RK bro. Doudrop seems to have a new faction, maybe? I don't know. It's a strange one because, obviously, Tamina is on Raw. Natalya is on SmackDown. They was together because of the brand crossover. But after Doudrop attacked Bianca, after her match with Tamina tonight, obviously that feud is continuing. But is this now a stable? Is this now a new female faction for WWE? If it is, are they going to be cross-brand? Because Natalya and Tamina could definitely go after the women's tag titles. We just spoke about the fact Carmella and Zelina do need opponents. Maybe they allow this. Hopefully. And also wanted to make sure I squeezed this in as well, so it's not all just negative news about Seth Rollins, because that fan incident obviously is a dominant news story. But Seth Rollins laid out Finn Balor. Finn Balor was completely obliterated by Seth Rollins. Seth even going back into the ring and actually hitting another curb stomp. Balor was out cold, and I'm into this. Was this going to be day one, maybe? Seth Rollins versus Finn Balor? Hell, bring out the demon. That would be super cool. Becky Lynch called out the WWE fans, and I don't blame her either. Last night, she spoke about the 10 women tag team match where the fans chanted for CM Punk. And of course, Becky Lynch called him out for it and said, 10 women were out here performing for you guys and doing an amazing job. And you came out here with your disgusting songs, your stupid chants. And then we as fans, you know, she didn't say this, but it's true. We as fans then wonder why a tournament like the Queen's Crown is then made to be a joke. It's such a shame. And now we seemingly as well know the debut date for Gable Steveson. There's so much hype for this Olympic gold medalist to make his WWE debut. He tweeted out earlier, December 13. Hopefully 13th of December. It is a Monday Night Raw. So we will wait and see if he shows up. But that was the excellent, exciting, extravagant, I'll stop now, Monday Night Raw. Overall, I think the show was good. I think I'll give the show a nice solid 8.5 out of 10. It was full of surprises. We had Kane's return and everything, which I thought was huge. Shocking, I know. There is no denying that the incident with Seth does take away from the show. It's hard to focus on after that. But when you look at what we actually got, it was a very, very entertaining Monday Night Raw for sure. WWE seemingly are making improvements, and I'm all here for that. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Like the video, and if you are new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on Twitter at CWrestlingUK, and I'll see you next time.